Hello, friends. Well, it appears, and it is no surprise, that Scott of Planet X is determined to prove he is an outsized fuckwit. Once again, in one of his latest videos, he has been insisting the Earth is tilting, and this is responsible for the weather being off. Most of us understand that the weather is being affected by climate change, and this is responsible for the extreme changes. So how can we show that the Earth tilt changing is bollocks? Well, I have an equatorial mounted telescope, and the Polestar Polaris are quite important to how it functions. For your latitude, you have to set the alignment of the scope to the same. I am at approximately 51 degrees latitude, and the EQ mounted telescope I have is set to the same according to the scale on the headset. Having set it 10 months ago, it's of no surprise to find that it still aligns with the Polestar Polaris, which is the Polestar for the Northern Hemisphere. If Earth had tilted, I, and millions of others who own EQ-mounted telescopes, would have had to change the angle to align with the Polestar again. Except Polaris would no longer be the hub around which the stars appear to rotate. So, in effect, we would have a new Polestar. So pictures like this would not be possible. Pictures of star trails with the camera pointed directly at the North Star. Or in fact, you don't have to point directly at the North Star. You will find the trails form around Polaris. You could be off centre, up, down, left, right. You would still get the circles of stars around Polaris. And therein lies the other proof that the tilt has not changed. As for the weather getting worse in the Northern Hemisphere, according to Scott, with his latest bollocks, well, climate change has had an effect on the weather up to a point. But as the Northern Hemisphere is now moving into winter, the weather is going to get windy, wet, blustery, and just generally horrible. This is normal for the time of year. Scott. In the animation, you can see that the seasonal changes are caused by Earth's orientation to the Sun. And this has been well known, well, since man got a grip of science, basically. The demonstration is a little simplified, as the orbit is elliptical, and this also plays a part in how hot or cold the summers or winters might be at any one time. But it is enough to demonstrate how Earth's position around the Sun is responsible for the seasons. I also kept it simple so Scott and his pet monkey may understand it. What am I saying? They don't give a shit. And so we return to Earth tilt as seen from the Discover satellite with its epic camera. Please observe the red dot on the coast of Africa, and how it is low when Africa is on the left side of the globe, and high when on the right. As you can see, this is because of the way the Earth is tilted. It now becomes apparent to those of us with the skill of comprehension that as the Discover satellite is always between the Sun and the Earth, that how Earth appears to the satellite is dependent on its position around the Sun during the year. In essence, the Earth tilt is not changing. It is the view of the satellite that is changing as the Earth orbits the Sun. Now, if Claudia or Scott need further diagrams, I have invested in some very pretty coloured crayons and big pieces of paper. I can create diagrams for the hard of understanding at a moment's notice. But of course, this is based on the assumption, yet again, that Scott and his pet monkey give a shit about accurate information, and indeed the truth.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.